Hey guys, Zen here, and today Ubisoft officially revealed the brand new defensive operator coming to Rainbow Six Siege, and her name is Maroa Evans, aka Clash. So let's take a quick peek at her, and we'll speak again soon.
This is where you stop.
Ubisoft also took to the blog and gives us a little more detail about her lore. They go on to say, born and raised in England, she's a tough officer who served with the Territorial Support Group holding the front line during the 2011 London riots. She earned her spot with the Specialist Firearms Command, making herself known within London's Metropolitan Police Services. She's an expert at devising crowd control strategies, and she's even acquired special permission to attend Gold Command meetings. She later made Detective Constable. Her experience, service record, and persistence in her line of work got her noticed by Rainbow Six. Twitch and Mira combined their engineering backgrounds, leading an R&D project to create the CCE Shield, Crowd Control Electro Shield. Clash is the perfect operator to handle this new gadget and weapon because she understands mob behavior and she pioneered snatch squad tactics, not to mention her experience as a riot officer. She knows exactly when and where to deploy this shield to deny entry and slow down her opponents. Not only that, Clash has the backbone to stand her ground and a cooperative mindset to set herself up for assist. She shows no mercy and she has zero tolerance for nonsense. Despite her new title as DC at the MPS, she knows she belongs on the front line. This new defender joining Rainbow Six, she's none other than Maroa Clash Evans. Now, as you can expect, many people in the community have been calling Clash the defensive version of Montaigne. She's got a big shield, she's mobile with it, and it basically covers her from every angle except the back. So, in general, I'd say that's a fair depiction of her functionality. Of course, what she brings additional to Monty is the Twitch-designed and inspired shock feature on her shield. If you could imagine, Thermite blows open the main garage on Chalet, for instance. Clash then pushes up into the now blown open hole with her gadget fully extended, blocking the ability for the attackers to push on through. But I think there's another level to this operator that I really haven't heard yet. So, we all know that she has this shocking ability, and most everyone has speculated that she uses this ability as a way to prevent both Thermite and Hibana from breaching further, and to a degree I can understand that, but I can't really understand Ubisoft implementing a mechanic where Thermite or Hibana can hard breach another operator, especially one equipped with a shield. And I also don't think Mira is getting enough credit with her contributions to this operator. My theory is that Clash has somewhat of a blinding ability using the light on the front of her shield, which is clearly shown off in this gif. Paired with the shock ability, I feel this is used as a way to disorient the enemy by both blinding and stunning them. Once stunned, I'm thinking Clash can drop the front visor of her shield, creating somewhat of a murder hole for defenders to shoot through. Ubisoft does mention that she sets herself up for assist, so this could possibly be the way that she does it best. And then she can redeploy the visor once the attacker's disorientation wears off, or whenever she so feels. Given the fact Mira is specifically mentioned to have worked with this operator, and knowing how Mira works, there's got to be some sort of drop-down window mechanic with this operator. I don't think Mira was just brought in to make bulletproof glass for this shield. She wasn't needed with Montaigne or Blitz for that matter, so why would she be needed here? Mira's specialty is manipulating her mirrors to be used as a tool, and I see no reason why the same wouldn't be applied here with Clash. This would also make perfect sense as to why the entire shield is transparent. As a peeking defender, you'd need to see as much of your target as possible to line up an accurate shot. So if her shield is always meant to be closed off and to be used as a barricade, there wouldn't really be a reason for it to be see-through. It could be possible I'm looking too far into this, but I see this as the best possible way for this operator to be played based on all the information we've gathered on her thus far. But that's everything, guys. That's the new defensive operator Clash coming in Operation Grim Sky and my thoughts on her. I want to hear from you. How do you think this operator works? And do you think my assessment of her is accurate? Let me know everything in a comment down below. If you did enjoy this video, please drop a like and subscribe with notifications if you're new. With that being said, it's been Zen.
Hey, I'm out.